After the flood of Noah, fallen entities from the oceans interacted with the human race all over again. The water nymph goddess Semiramis was one of them. She was known as Inanna in Sumer, and this happened more than 4,000 years ago. Whenever I talk about this water nymph turned queen, Semiramis, many are very quick to say that she lived around 800 BC, confusing her with Queen Shammuramut of King Shalmaneser III. However, the Chaldean priest turned historian Barossus agrees with what I have been saying all along. I found the details of what he said in an old book printed in the year 1601 AD. But before we read that passage, here's a brief outline of who Barossus was. Barossus was a contemporary of Alexander the Great, and he was a priest of Bel from Babylon. He knew a lot about the ancient history from the temple inscriptions. During his lifetime, the Greeks were ignorantly merging the identities of Semiramis and Tammuz with those of Isis and Horus of Egypt. In order to set the record right, Barossus wrote the following in one of his books. Rhea delivered a daughter called Juno, which was also called Isis the Great, and this was in the first year of the reign of Semiramis, which was 302 years after the flood. He further goes on to say that Ninus the Younger, which is Tammuz, was Semiramis' son, which also implies that Ninus the Elder was the Nimrod she enticed and killed. However, in spite of all his attempts, the Greeks' version of the story prevailed, and it still does. After all, after the conquest of the Near East by Alexander the Great, the Greeks treated the Babylonians like they knew nothing at all as compared to the Greeks themselves. Meanwhile, all the books that Barossus wrote were also conveniently lost somehow. Now, don't you smell like something is smoking? I do. Thanks for watching.